What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl, April. So you guys already know what day of the week it is. It's Wednesday. And yes, it is Real Talk Wednesday time. Okay, so I hope you guys had like a fantabulous Thanksgiving. Ate, got your bellies full, especially because you guys were able to see family and friends. So I hope that went well for you. A lot of people don't have that out there. A lot of people get depressed around the holiday season. So let's just keep that in mind. You know, if you know someone who doesn't have family or many friends, invite them over. Share some good times with them. Make some good memories with them. You know what I'm saying? Do some fun things. Just keep in mind that it's the holiday season and we don't have to go all out and spend a whole bunch of money. But I think what a lot of things count is that it's family. You know what I'm saying? Like, for me personally, I was just happy that it was me and my kids, and not all of my kids and not all of my grandkids. You know what I'm saying? My son that's in New York, he wasn't here, unfortunately, and neither was my grandson, which is his son. So I did miss out on those two things, you know what I'm saying? But I did have my other kids and my grandson here and my son's best friends who are like my kids too. But I really enjoy spending family time, you know what I mean? I don't like to put on a big hoorah. I do enough cooking so that the entire neighborhood, if they were hungry, they could come. And by the time I'm done cooking, I don't even want to eat because I'm so tired, you know? So I felt like this was a great Thanksgiving. Though I missed some of my family members a lot, it still was a blessing to just be able to spend it with my family. And despite the bullshit that went on throughout the day, not with me, but with emails, like, okay, I understand that you run a business, but here's the thing, and I posted it on Instagram, a little snippet video. Now, I put a video up on YouTube on Thanksgiving. Was I saying Christmas this whole time? If I wasn't, excuse me. But anyway, did I get an email from a company who sent me some free shit? Okay, they sent me some free shit. In return, I did a video for them. You did not pay me to do the video. I did the video because that's just what I do. You know what I'm saying? I like to get free stuff in the mail, like I told you guys. And here's the thing. Don't fucking harass me on Thanksgiving, on a holiday, asking me, well, I didn't see your video that you posted and the coupon code, etc., etc. Did I go off in the email? Was like, well, happy Thanksgiving to you and your family as well. Your video is up on YouTube. Won't you just go on my channel and look for it? I don't work on holidays, and I especially don't work for YouTube on holidays neither. Enjoy your family and friends today. Left it at that, and it was all in caps. So you know I was fucking yelling. Did they email me back like the next day and was like, thank you, we love the video, happy Thanksgiving to you too? Like, bitch, did you just see that I spazzed out on you? And I don't really want to hear from you, you know what I'm saying? Like, these companies have no consideration. I got the one who's talking about they shit, and I already told you I just came out of surgery and I'm sleeping, and you still want to talk about that shit. That's why, like I put in the video, I got some bullshit in the mail. Then, you know, it's like no consideration. These companies, all they would care about is money, money, money. They got people coming into work on Thanksgiving. Like, really, it's Family Dollar. It's Dollar Tree. It's stores like that. Like, any store in general. Could you at least close for the day so these people can enjoy their family? But no, people want to rush out and buy sneakers and iPads and dumb shit like that on Thanksgiving Day. Like, people have lost the true value and meaning of holidays and family, and that's just so inconsiderate. I don't do the Black Fridays for one, because for one, we already know what Black Friday is from or what it stands for. Okay, for two, I'm not about to get up out of my bed early in the morning and have nobody pushing on and shoving on me in a fucking store. I've already done that like so many years ago. I probably like 6 years ago was the last time I went to a Black Friday sale, and I'll never forget, this lady shoved the shit out of me in the back, you know, like in my backside area with a shopping cart in Walmart. Like, really, you want to get through? But she shoved the fucking crap out of me. What did I do as a reflex in return? I turned around and shoved the shit out of her. You know what I'm saying? Like, really, I was much bigger than her. Pushed the shit out of her. She went flying backwards. Like, people just don't know how to act. And I just think it's ridiculous how people act over certain items. Like, it's Black Friday. Those items that they got, you really think you're saving a lot of money then continue to shop on Black Friday? Me, I wait for a good sale. I buy stuff throughout the year. So that way, when Black Friday comes, I don't even have to worry about none of that bullshit that y'all motherfuckers is getting up at like 2, 3 in the morning for. Trust me, I've done that. And I'm like so over it. You know what I mean? I'm so over it. But other than that, it was a great Thanksgiving, great holiday for me. Got on my blonde hair, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Oh, and I guess you guys, I hope you guys remember. If y'all don't, remember like I was saying last week how I was at the Chinese market and a gentleman asked me for my phone number. You know what I'm saying? This black guy. You know what I'm saying? But remember, I told you guys that he kept looking at me like real thirsty. You know what I'm saying? Like gawking and just like, you know, he was like 1 centimeter off of drooling at the mouth. Anyway, so he doesn't text me until like on Thanksgiving Day, which was like 2 days later. And that's fine because I really didn't want you to be bothering me like that. I don't text people. Well, not people, but I don't text guys. You know what I'm saying? If I'm not really interested. So anyway, he texted me on Thanksgiving and I said, Happy Thanksgiving. And I said, Happy Thanksgiving to you as well. Like 3 days later, he texts me at 5 in the morning. It was like 5:21 in the morning, talking about, oh wow, let me see where this text message is at. Okay. Damn, I just was thinking about you and never seen this message. Happy late Thanksgiving to you too. Like, okay, you're the one who started the text message. So you texted me back on a Sunday at 5:51 a.m. Like, what the fuck was you thinking about me for at 5:51 a.m.? You don't even know me to be thinking about me. Whatever. I didn't even respond to the message. I just left it alone. So he texts me yesterday. And it was 12:18 in the afternoon. Did this nigga text me good evening? 2 hours went by and I decided to respond. Now, that could tell you I'm not really interested at all. I write, do you mean good afternoon? He writes back, yes, how you doing? An hour goes by when I respond back. I mean, I've seen the text message, but I didn't really feel like no need in responding to you. I was like, I'm good, and how about you? He's like, I'm good, but tired. I said, that's nice to hear. Working so much made you tired. This is what he texts back. Working, drinking, and eating. I need something else to eat besides all this food. Now, already in my head, I'm like, hold the fuck up. I know he ain't trying to text fresh to me because he don't even know me. Okay, this is like the second time we've had a conversation. And this ain't even a verbal conversation. This is through a text message. So, hold the fuck up. I was like, oh, really? Okay, what else is there besides food to eat? Because I already knew, but I want to see where you're going with this. I said, maybe you should work out instead of eating so much. Or did you mean you need something else to do besides eating all that food? Yeah, anyway, I've been working a lot too. And I'm actually working right now. I'm pretty busy. This is him now. Where you work at? I need some pussy to eat. I'm full of food. I had to let like 30 minutes go by before responding back to this because I just was like, wow. First of all, I don't think you need to know what I do for a living. Second of all, you shouldn't come so strong and seem so thirsty in a text message to some woman you don't even know because not all females are like that. If you think that's a turn on to me, then guess again because I'm not one of these females that you randomly meet or know that goes for talking to someone like this. Oh, I apologize. It just came off my tongue like that. I didn't mean any harm by it. Listen. I continued and was like, you know what? No worries. But if you got a problem, maybe you should go take that up with someone else. But don't take it up with me because I'm not the one. And like I said, I don't deal with thirsty motherfuckers. Okay? I ended it like that. He continued to text me and apologize. But at that point, I was like, you know, he did say, you know, I apologize. I thought you was going to curse me out. I had to let him know, listen, first of all, I don't have time to curse anybody out. There's a block button on my phone and I can easily do that. I've done it to many people. I'm not about to go out of character and stress myself out for some nigga that I don't know. Are you crazy? I don't let men get me all stressed the fuck out. And this is what I wrote him. I said, you really don't know me that well. Just not forget that I am a grown ass woman. Okay, I've been married and sent a nigga on his way packing back to New York. So you got the wrong female for this. I left it at that. This is what I'm talking about men. Some men, not all. They just be so thirsty. Like, who writes some shit like that to somebody? Like, you don't even know me. You met me, I think it was like the day before, 2 days before Thanksgiving, and on a Tuesday, and it's a Monday, and we have not spoke verbally on the phone. We have not seen each other. None of that. You know what I'm saying? For you to tell me that, it's like, are you out your motherfucking mind? But you know what's so sad about it? Some women will go crazy over shit like that. Like, oh, yes, this nigga like me. He talking about he want to eat my pussy. Bitch, if he say some shit like that to you and he just met you, I wouldn't even kiss him with somebody else's fucking lips, okay? Because God forbid, and God only knows where his mouth has fucking been, all right? If he could come out his face randomly and tell you how he want to eat some pussy because he full of eating food and don't even know you. For all you know, I could have a nasty, infected, infested, stank ass coochie, and you talking about you want to eat the shit? This is the shit I be talking about. This is why I just leave motherfuckers alone, regardless of the race, the color, or whatever the fuck you are. It's because of shit like this. Like, because of men like him, I will come so out of character with myself that it's not even funny. Like, who are you talking to? Like, you're 37 years old. You approach women like that? I could not believe. Like, I already knew what he was getting at when he said, oh, I'm full of food, I don't want to eat. All this. I already knew what he was coming, but I just wanted to make sure that I wasn't bugging out and read what the fuck he had to say. Like, maybe he might say something different. You never know. But I was right. I was right. This nigga talking about eating pussy. Like, thirsty. And I also did have to tell, I said, maybe if you wouldn't come so strong and be so thirsty, you might get lucky and get some pussy from somebody. But the way you come at people, don't nobody want to give you none. Like, seriously. And I'm definitely not. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know you, dude. Like, back the fuck off. Let me tell you something. I wouldn't give a fuck who lips his mouth was on, okay? If it was Denzel's, if it was The Game, if it was, who else do I like? I don't really, Jason Statham, George Clooney. I don't give a fuck if your lips was on they face. There is no way you was putting your lips anywhere near me. You wouldn't even, I wouldn't even let you kiss my motherfucking hand, okay? Thirst bucket. This nigga is a thirst bucket. I told y'all, when you can look at somebody so hard and look like you want to sock them up with a biscuit and a side of gravy, then there's something wrong with you. Like, I really felt like he was being thirsty just out the gate. Like, that shit might work for some females, but for me, I find that as a huge form of disrespect. And I'm a motherfucking lady, and you're going to treat me like a motherfucking lady. I don't give a fuck how much vulgar and cursing and bluntness I am. I'm still, at the end of the day, a motherfucking lady. And nigga, if I got to put you in your place and go upside your goddamn dome piece and skull and knock you the fuck out and beat you to the black fall off or white or orange or whatever the fuck it is, you going to know that I am a motherfucking lady. Bottom line. So yes, had to share that with you guys. Now y'all see why I just stay by myself, solo, dolo, with my kids, and that's about it, because I just really don't need a motherfucking headache. You know what I'm saying? I'm not about to get no headache, and if I was, I damn sure ain't about to let no man, no motherfucker, give me no headache. Bottom line. I just really could not believe that shit. I guess he figured I was supposed to be like, oh, for real? Oh, well, I got something over here for you if you hungry. Nigga, please. You'd be starving, dead, on your last motherfucking limb if I was to feed you. So anyway, if you guys have a Real Talk video that you want done on this channel, make sure you send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please put in the subject line Real Talk. If you want to go ahead and change the characters of the people in your email, meaning their names, not change, but change their names, then please go ahead and do so and just let me know that in the beginning of the email. If you didn't catch my email address, then check below in the description box. It is there for you guys, as well as my my wig website, and other links that you may want. You know, it is the holiday. A lot of people like to drink and drive. So if you want to take an Uber on me for free, there is a link for that, as well as Lyft, which is just like Uber. But Lyft is not in all states like Uber, but it's exactly the same. So I do have two links for that where you guys can get yourself a free ride on April. So in that case, let's get on to this real talk, you guys. Okay. Hey, April, let me start off by saying that I love your channel and you always make my day with your videos. Okay, so I thought that I would take a chance and ask your advice since you always keep it real, and at that moment, that's exactly what I need. So I'll try to keep it short and simple. I've been talking to this guy for a few years over Facebook that I met on a dating site, like 7 years or so. And recently, he told me that he wanted to give us a try after like five previously failed attempts. It was a fail on both of our parts. So anyway, I agreed to it, and he asked me to come with him to Florida on a business trip in December so we could finally meet and talk face to face. I accepted, but I'm starting to notice his lack of communication, and that makes me nervous since I already bought my ticket to meet him in his hometown, Philly, which is where we're supposed to be flying from. He always claiming he's busy with work, which is why he doesn't really text or call. And I mean, I understand that, but when I check Facebook, he has time to be out at dinner with friends or posting shit. Now, I'm not clingy in the least, and I'm not saying he shouldn't go out and have fun, but literally, if I don't text him 9 times out of 10, I don't hear back. I'm just at a loss, especially since there are no refunds on plane tickets, but I feel some type of way and now I don't even want to go. I mean, I just feel unimportant to him now and I'm not sure what to do. Sorry this is long-winded, girl, but I need advice. Thanks in advance. So we just gonna call her Kimberly. Also, before I even get into this, I wanted to say thank you to one of my subscribers, which is Nicole. I do believe that's her name, if I forgot. No, it is Nicole. It is. I'm pretty sure it is. She sent me an email yesterday, and it was a gift for my daughter, Mumsy. And I did email her back and tell her thank you, but I just wanted to say thank you again because she apparently watches my Real Talk. And I just wanted to tell her thank you so much because, you know, I appreciate everybody on here, and if you send something to my daughter through email, through the mail, you know what? It is so much appreciated. A lot of people are so kind of like, not transparent, but a lot of people are just bougie. Some people just don't take the time out to thank people. Or a lot of people in general just don't appreciate the little things. You know what I'm saying? And me personally, I have come from nothing. And I still feel like that sometimes. You know what I mean? I don't have everything. But the little bit that I do have, I am so happy and blessed. And I give anything to anybody. You know what I'm saying? So I don't have to have the riches because I don't. But let me tell you something. The riches to me is the little bit of stuff that I have. You know what I'm saying? I go to thrift stores. I go to clearance racks, and that's how I live my life, you know, budget friendly, because I ain't made of money and money ain't made of me. But I just wanted to let you guys know, appreciate everything you have, because I appreciate all you guys. And I just wanted to say thank you so much, because you really don't know what you did for Mumsy. She was so happy. Like, it was like such an unexpected gift. And Mumsy's eyes was like lit up. She was so happy and excited, like totally excited. So she is so thankful. So I just wanted to tell you thank you from the both of us. And yes, thank you everybody for everything you have done for me. Even if you guys feel like y'all haven't done anything, just by watching me, you guys have done something for me, because it allows me to feel like I'm not doing this for nothing. You know what I'm saying? At least you guys are giving me some attention and some feedback, so I appreciate that. So now let's get into this real talk. So Kimberly, basically, this is crazy because Kimberly's been talking to this dude. We're gonna call him Ryan. She's been talking to him for 7 years on she met him through a dating website, and they've been talking for 7 years over Facebook that they met on a dating site. So they text and they call. They've never even met face to face. And so they have tried the dating thing 5 times. And so now they're finally going to meet up with each other and meet each other after 7 fucking years. But, you know, he invited her to go on a business trip with him in December to Florida. So to me, if you invite me for one, that means, nigga, you're going to pay my way. Okay, you're going to pay my ticket. But he didn't, because obviously she's complaining about you can't get no refunds on plane tickets. You can't get your money back. So She doesn't even want to go now because he isn't communicating with her. And like she said, 9 times out of 10, if she doesn't reach out to him, she's not hearing from him. And he's always saying how he's busy with work, et cetera, et cetera. But he's always got time to be on Facebook with friends and family, posting pictures and stuff, et cetera, et cetera. But never has time to like respond to a text message or make a phone call or to reach out to her. But let me tell you something. She don't want to go on a trip no more. She feel like she just wasted her time. Boo, you did waste your motherfucking money. Let me tell you something. There's no way on God's green earth am I about to sit around for 7 motherfucking years and not be able to meet the person that I'm so-called supposedly dating. I'm not dating someone for 7 years and never meeting them. That's not even a fucking date. That's called foolishness, okay? We're not going to go back and forth with each other like you pen pals in jail and make friends and nicey-nicey. You know what I'm saying? For all that, bitch, find a nigga in your hometown. Fuck this nigga out of town. He's so busy that he doesn't text or call. You know, a lot of times when niggas are too busy, they say that they don't, they too busy to text and call, and you hear from them like once in a blue moon, very scarcely. That probably more than likely means that they too busy fucking the next bitch, meaning they got a family life going on. They got a woman at home. They live with the bitch, okay? You cannot be texting another bitch while you around your main bitch. Like, that's not possible. You know what I'm saying? And you can't damn near FaceTime neither. So if you want to continue to believe that, oh, he's too busy with work to text and make a phone call, then keep fucking believing that shit. Because it only take 2 minutes, not even, to call somebody and say, hey, how the fuck is your day? How you doing? Or hello, how's your day? Life is not that hectic for some people. I fail to believe that. I'm not even going to believe that shit. Like, if you tell me you're too busy, then I'm not going to believe it. Me, I say that too sometimes. And I do be very, very busy in my life. Just the only time I get rest is when I go to sleep. I went to bed at 10 o'clock last night, like, meaning I didn't go to sleep, but I laid in the bed. And my kids were looking at me like I was crazy because they know I never get into bed until like 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning. Because I'm usually at my computer editing a video, making a wig, or doing something like that. So sometimes we do get a little unbusy where we can relax and we can text people. However, my day is always very hectic and always very busy because I have a grandson to tend to while my daughter is at work. I have children that I pick up from school and bring to work. I have a grandson that I run around after. I have a wig business that I'm making. I'm editing videos. I'm recording videos. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just going to the store and running errands. So my life is very busy. However, I always find time to text somebody or have a phone call. Yeah, maybe we can't be on the phone for 2 or 3, 4 hours, bitch. But I'm just saying, I can text you the fuck back and say, hello, how you doing? Or listen, I can't talk right now because I'm busy. I can answer the phone and do that or even talk to you. Listen, my boo thing, Miss Shay Love, who's on YouTube, we're not boo things, but she's like my best friend. I did a video last week with her on speaker while I was doing and styling the wig, and she didn't even know until I told her, listen, I'm gonna call you back. I'm finished styling this wig. I was doing a video. I'm gonna call you right back. She didn't even know. I was busy, but I still made time. You know what I'm saying? So I don't really believe that people can be so busy to where they can't text you once a day or call you once a day. Don't believe the hype, okay? Don't believe the hype. If you don't know where that song came from, sweetheart, but I don't know what to tell you. KRS-One, that was Flavor Flav and then Public Enemy. But I'm about to tell you like this. That nigga ain't too busy for fucking hanging out with his friends and shit like that. So don't think that for once he ain't too busy for you. He's too busy because he got somebody. And now you going on a business trip with him because that's out of town. It's away from his family. Business trip. It couldn't be nothing besides a business trip. You just couldn't take a trip out of the ordinary. So he's leaving to go do something for work. And that's the only time that he don't have to bring his family along with him or explain to his wife or his girl, his fiance, baby mama, whatever the drama may be that live in his household or who he live with. Like, listen, I gotta go out of town for work. I can't bring you. He don't even have to explain that to that bitch. But you are going with him on a business trip. And now he is not communicating with you because, for one, he's busy at home with his female, okay? If you don't hear from him like that, then listen. I don't know what to tell you, but I'm not going to allow you to get your hopes up high. Now, yeah, you can't get a refund on plane tickets. That's right. You are definitely correct about that. However, what you can get is you can get to use that plane ticket again within a year. So if you don't take that plane trip because you feel uncomfortable now, sweetheart, you can use that plane ticket for another travel. You don't have to go to that specific state, but that money will go towards a new plane ticket. So if you feel the need to not go, all you need to do is call the plane ticket, the plane station, the plane company, the airplane company, whatever, and explain to them your situation. You don't even have to tell them your business. Just let them know, listen, I'm not going to be taking that trip. I need to know what you guys can do for me, confirmation number, how I can use this in a later purchase or whatever. You never know. You may want to get out and go somewhere out of town with your girlfriends or what have you. Either way, give that to somebody who may be in need of it, but don't feel like it's going to waste. What is going to waste is your 7 years of sitting around waiting for a motherfucker that really ain't too concerned about you. I'm sorry, are we on MTV's Catfish? Like, I watch that show a lot, and I just be looking at the people on there like, you fucking stupid. Like, where do we meet somebody online? We've never met them face-to-face, and we ain't even had a face-to-face over the computer with them, okay? But we just sit on the phone and talk verbally and text. That's all we do, okay? But we've never had a Skype. We've never had a meetup and greet up. We've never had any of that. And you fit, and you're going to continuously date this person. Like, I have seen people on these shows dating people for like 10 and 12 years. And then finally, when it's time for them to meet them, because they feel some type of way after like 10 years, they call the show up. And it's not even a person who they think it is. Like, they're like, but I looked at their photos. You dumb fuck. Those are photos. You can get those anywhere. Let me tell you something. This bitch named Kiana, what was her name? Natasha Knowles. Like Beyonce Knowles, Natasha Knowles. Someone brought this to my attention years ago. This bitch made a whole Facebook page up. Her profile was me. She was me. All her pictures. Every time I would upload a picture, this bitch would steal them and take them and put them on her Facebook page. No lie, no kidding. So she was catfishing everybody. And it was like so ridiculous. They never shut her Facebook page down. I don't even know if she's still doing this. I haven't checked in like the past few years. At first, it seemed like, oh, flattery to me. Like, oh, okay, she must really, really like me. But then I just started seeing shit like, this bitch is like really thinking that she's me. Like, why the fuck would you want to be me? Bitch, I got a lot of shit that you really don't want, okay? Like a bunch of kids, a bunch of bills, a bunch of debt, bad credit. I can go on and go on and on and on and on. But yes, it's catfishing. And I just be like, you motherfuckers, some people be so stupid to fall for shit. Like, is it that much desperation in the world where you feel like an internet relationship is a good thing? Like, you cool with being in a relationship with somebody that you never even met over the internet? Like, I'm sorry, I need a whole lot more than just a fucking text message and some phone calls. Like, I need more than that. And if that's all you can give me, then I guess that's not good enough for me. But I'm not about to sit around and wait for somebody for 7 years that I've never even met, okay? And now you guys are finally going to start dating each other. Like, what made him even say that? Like, after 5 failed attempts and shit, he now wants to start trying shit? Listen, let me tell you something, sweetheart. Call the plane company and let them put that ticket money to something else. Stop wasting your time on somebody who's already taken, or somebody who's got a whole different agenda. For all you fucking know, he's not even who he says he the fuck is, okay? And your ass has been catfished for 7 years. I'm not about to let anybody string me along for that fucking long period of time. There's no way on God's green earth are you about to have this bitch sitting here on any type of social media conversing back and forth with you, and I've never got to meet you. You crazy. And you fucking crazy to just continuously carry on with the relationship. Girl, please. I had a long time ago left this motherfucker a long, long time ago. So there goes your help right there. And Divas, what would y'all do? Like, because that catfishing is real. And there's a lot of dumb motherfuckers out there. And I'm sorry for those of you guys who have been having internet relationships for 5 and 10 years that is watching this and feel like I'm wrong. Because Listen, bitches, if you ain't never met the motherfucker within a year, then there's something wrong with you. And me personally, you got 6 months for us to have a meetup and greet up. And after that, I'm not fucking with you because you're not about to string me the fuck along. And I'm not going to feel like a donkey. And when I say a donkey, I mean an ass. Okay? Okay. Hello, April. I am a new subscriber, and I have been binge-watching your videos. I admire you, your channel, and your real advice. Call me Sandy. I have or had a friend. Let's call her Tina. Tina and I have known each other since sixth grade. She's been a solid friend through my high school pregnancy and related drama as I have to her. She moved 6 hours away for college, where she remained for 5 years. Last year, she moved back to town, and we began to hang out again. Only she's not the same Tina. I know people change, but this was shocking. Even though she is a beautiful, sexy, college-educated BBW, she lacks confidence. I try to help her by giving her compliments and pointing out her many great attributes. I also try to give her a glimpse of what it's really like to be married with children. It's a struggle. The mortgage, daycare, bills, food tabs, health insurance, co-pays, glasses, you name it. She often tells me I have the perfect life and am grateful and ungrateful for my blessings. That is not true. I have only been trying to tell her the good, the bad, and the ugly. She is too shy to talk to men and too nervous when they talk to her. So she kicks herself after she feels like she made a fool of herself. Our friendship became strained because she couldn't talk about anything anymore. We couldn't talk about anything anymore. I couldn't share good news for fear she'd feel bad, and I couldn't vent for fear of her feeling like I was ungrateful. So fast forward, she completely stops answering the phone, texts, and emails. Our last conversation was pleasant with plenty of laughs. April, she ghosted me, and it hurt so bad. I thought we were better friends than that. For God's sake, we're over 30 years old. Who does that? I know she's okay because I saw a Facebook post of her at a party with some family. What should I do? Should I just drive to her house and try to get some closure, or take a hint and let it be? It's been 8 months since we last spoke. Sandy. Wow. So Sandy's friend Tina is basically an introvert. I think that's what they call. She's just shy. She doesn't like to talk. She's scared to talk to guys. She's lonely and she just lacks self-confidence. I remember those days a lot. You know what I'm saying? A lot. I can remember those. Like, trust and believe, I was not always loud and arrogant and bossy like I am now, okay? But I've always been open, very opinionated, but never so blunt. Like, I don't know. I guess I've gotten like that over many years. I just don't give a fuck about what people think anymore. But so she misses her friendship with her friend because basically they've been friends since they was like 6 years old. And the young lady finally moved back to the town and they started hanging out and et cetera, et cetera. And then they just stopped speaking. The girl has ghosted her, basically stopped answering text messages, phone calls, emails, and everything. And it's probably has a lot to do with how she feels about you. She just may be a jealous female, and that's okay. And it may not be as in a jealous way, like a meanful, green-eyed monster type of way. You know, some people, they do lack confidence, and they just feel like whatever they do, they don't have it. You know what I'm saying? And regardless of what you do or say to them to make them boost their ego or boost their self-confidence, it doesn't work until they are able to do it on their own. You know what I'm saying? Me personally, I don't really know too many people like that, but if that is really your true friend and you care about her like that, and even though she has ghosted you, sometimes two wrongs don't make a right, and sometimes you have to let the person see and realize, listen, I'm here for you, I am your friend, you know, and you know she's okay and she's fine, but you still want closure, and there's nothing wrong with closure. Like, a lot of us, it's hard for us to just leave a friendship and go on without closure. Me, for one, I'm okay with that. Like, I don't really need closure with anybody. If I stop fucking with you, I just stop fucking with you, and I have my reasons, you know what I'm saying? And even though you may need the closure, I don't really feel like I have to give that to you, because 9 times out of 10, if I stop fucking with you, it's because of something that you have done to me, whether you know it or not. It's something that you have done to me, and over a period of time, it starts to eat at me, and it's like, you know what? It's best if I just wing away from this person and leave them the fuck alone before I spaz the fuck out, and then they really see how April is, and they really don't like me. So I don't really need closure with a lot of people, and I don't really feel like I need to give it to people. But there's nothing that you have done, and there's nothing that she has done but just ghost you. And, you know, a lot of people are hermits in a shell. They don't get out. You know, I know one person that's like that. Unfortunately, it's my mom. And even though me and she and I are not the best of friends, and you guys already know that with her and I, she is just completely like that herself. She's kind of shy. She's the same way. She's shy. She'll go in the house and stay in the house. She doesn't have any friends but one. She lacks self-confidence. The same thing. So I don't know if her lacking certain things in life, just makes her mean and evil towards me because I'm total opposite of her. I really don't know. But I do know that my mom is like that. She's like a hermit. Like, she doesn't have any friends. She doesn't do anything. And she just lets life just whittle away. You know what I'm saying? And that shit gets to be very boring. But on another note, you know, maybe that's one reason why me and her don't get along, is because maybe she feels like I'm not like her, and maybe that might be her jealousy of me. You know what I'm saying? Some people get jealous over the littlest things, and you never know. And sometimes you have to approach them and let them know, like, listen, what I have is the same things that you can have and better. Or, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people, you just need to talk to them. It ain't about building their confidence up, because I'm sorry, I'm not going to keep trying to build up your motherfucking confidence, and you ain't trying to build that shit up. Like, I'll be more than happy to help you, but if you're not willing to help yourself, then what the fuck am I supposed to do? Be your motherfucking coach? Like, bitch, no. Mm-mm. What I would do, honestly, Sandy, is I would go to Tina's house. Fuck that. You know what I'm saying? That's your friend. You have done nothing to her besides be a friend and try to introduce her to a world. What I would do is go over and say, hey, knock on the motherfucking door. Listen, we need to have a talk, because last time I heard from you was 8 months ago. You have been ignoring my emails, ignoring my phone calls and text messages. And I need to know what's going on, because I need to know, is there something that I've done to you? If there is, can you please let me know? We could talk about this, because we have been friends since childhood. That would be me, especially if it was a friend through childhood. But if we were friends, like, as grown-ups, listen, and some dumb shit popped off, I'm not gonna allow you to stress me the fuck out like that, because you know better. You know what I'm saying? But if we, like, friends since 6th grade or 6 years old or whatever, and you know there's nothing that you've done, then I would definitely go and say something to her. Sometimes people be in such a shell that they don't know what to do. And sometimes it's like this. She may be afraid to approach you, and as time goes by and ticks and goes longer and prolongs, she may feel embarrassed or somewhat just feel like, damn, maybe I can't say anything to her now because it's been 8 months. So she may be feeling like that as well. So I wouldn't call it a quits and just get the hint and move on. Try to get some type of closure from her, because that is your friend. And she may be feeling the same way, like, hey, maybe I need to apologize. But, you know, some people, like you said, she's shy. She don't really know how to open up. Take her out. If she is willing to be still friends with you and remain, like, the best of friends, I would, like, try to have a girls' day with her. And not just you and her, you know, because that's fine with just you and her. But maybe if you have other friends, like a girls' day, like two other friends, you can invite them, and then she can see what it's like to be part of a group and a girl thing, like a girls' circle. Have fun together. You know what I mean? A lot of females, they don't have that. Me, for one, I don't have, like, a group of friends. I definitely don't have a group of friends out here. You know, and the friend that I do have, who I'm always raving about, well, that lives out here, girl, please, listen, the same thing with her. I invite her to my home all the time. She lives really close by me. I invite her to my home all the time. You can come over whenever you want. You can come over whenever you want. I invite her to every function that I have, family function. She never comes through. But then she always tells me to come over, and I come over. We'll sit there and we'll drink wine and talk the shit. But you can never come to my house. And I'm tired of that shit. So, you know, I did invite her for Thanksgiving, and of course she didn't show up. And that's fine, because listen, more food for me and my family. That's okay. But I tell you what, shit like that starts to eat at me after a while. And the type of person I am, I will stop fucking with you in a total, like, like not even mess with you at all because I don't have time for it. I'm not about to chase anybody to be your friend. You know what I mean? But then there's the other side of me because she did not know me prior to YouTube. She just knew me. She met me. She did not know who I was because she doesn't watch YouTube. So that was the part that really was like, okay, she's a really true friend. And I've had lots of opportunities to make friends out here with a lot of different people. But sometimes I just hold back because it's like, you know what? You guys only, like, not you guys, but, like, I have to second think, like, do they want to just be my friend because I'm muffin as my lovers or what have you? So it's kind of hard for me to have, like, a lot of friends because I don't really know their true intentions. And sometimes a lot of people do have trust issues, you know what I'm saying? Because I just want someone to be my friend for me, you know what I'm saying? And like me for me, not for who I am on the internet, but just for April. Not for muffin as my lovers, but just for April. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, I would definitely go over there and see what's going on with her and just find out, hey, what's good? You know what I mean? Because she might be depressed. Shit like that depresses people. When she starts talking about you're ungrateful, you don't know what a blessing you have, even though you may feel like it's bothering her or you don't want to talk about it around her, a lot of things like that depress people. When they see other families out there and they don't have one of their own, they're not in a relationship, it gets to a person after a while. You know, I have been there in that situation where it's gotten to me after a while. You know, I used to go out, my ex-husband would be in jail, and I would see all these couples holding hands, having their babies, pushing their babies. How the fuck do you guys think I felt? I'm pregnant and I'm not holding anybody's hand but my kids, okay? And this nigga's in jail. Like, and I would be like, damn, I wish I had that. I wish I had that. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I feel like that still. I'm not pregnant, okay? But I see couples and they all loving and shit and I are on Instagram or whatever in person. And I just be feeling the same way. Like, damn, why that couldn't be me? Why I can't find somebody that's special? Why I can't, you know, be in love with somebody? Why I can't find somebody that's going to just love me truly for me? And, you know, I feel like that sometimes too. And I it's not that I get jealous, but I feel like that as well. And I just be like, damn, why can't I have that? But then again, you don't really know what goes on behind closed doors with these people that you're seeing. You know what I'm saying? You just see in the outside. The grass is not always green on the other side. I'm just saying. So, yeah, Sandy, I will go and check on her and see what's really good. Put your A game down and let that bitch know what's really good. You know what I'm saying? And on that note, divas, I hope you enjoyed this real talk. Of course, there will be more next week. Stay diva and divalicious. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe. Make sure you check the other video for today because I always put a beauty video out. So on that note, leave all your comments below for these two young ladies. And let me know what you thought about that thirsty-ass nigga's text message to me. I love you guys, and I'll see you soon.